Are you seeing that eventually this ends up to be a Romualdez Duterte war in the upcoming elections? Are you seeing that?
Hindi ako masyadong takot diyan, sir. Mas natatakot ako yung nangyayari sa West Philippine Sea. Mahirap yun, Karen. Halimbawa, this is not a question of patriotism. This is a question of madness. Paano ka naman makipag-away sa China doon? Isipin mo, isusubok mo yung coast guards natin doon. They are military. They will be massacred worse than Mama Sapano.
All right, so wait, what you're saying, okay, this is a whole other topic altogether. So you have to forgive me. We don't have time for this one, but what you're saying is you don't agree with the foreign policy of President Marcos Jr., right? That's what your
Definitely,
point. Okay, but
yes.
that's a whole other topic. Okay, but at the end of the day, your issue is you will not support charter change. You believe this administration, the leadership of Congress, has other motivations. It's to perpetuate himself in power. That's what you believe.
Yes.
Okay, all right. And in effect, mahirap lang natanggalan ng probinsya ninyo, yung distrito nyo, ng pondo for the projects you need to prevent flooding.
That is correct.
Okay. All right. But is it right to say your allies now with the Dutertes again, both the former president and Sara? Is it with you and Sara, everything's forgotten?
I have not talked to the Vice President, but the former President Duterte, nag-usap po kami.
And what did you tell him? I'll support your daughter. What did you say?
Hindi naman specifically ganun grabe, but sabi ko lang sa kanya na, at the rate we are going now, yung bansa, no? Yung mga problema na nakaharap sa bansa, ay kinakailangan magkaisa din kami.
Okay. All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today. It's always interesting to speak with you. Thank you so much for joining me today, Representative Pantaleon Alvarez. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen.